1951. Hollywood stars in transit to Brazil arrive in Porto, Spain. It's the year of the triumphal return of the Trinidad All-Steel Percussion Orchestra.
Now, first of all, coming up here, we have one member. What's your name?
Danny Smith.
And what was your trip like over there?
Well, the trip was a great success. It was nice, you know.
You had a lot of engagement?
Yes, we had a lot of engagement right after. Next year, what? On account of some of the boys, what who was taking that, that boy is a bit of a member who so he had to bring us back.
Well, how did you enjoy the trip on the whole and the people and everything?
Well, we enjoyed it all right. The people were very nice. They didn't want us to come back so quick. Especially the people in London. They like to see them a lot.
A hurricane hits Jamaica. The West Indies cricket team leaves for Australia. The matches are heard from Australia. The Strand Cinema swings open its doors in Port of Spain. His Majesty King George VI sends Christmas greetings.
From the Queen and I wish you all, near and far, a happy Christmas and a prosperous and peaceful New Year.
Winifred Atwell returns in triumph to her homeland.
What would be your advice, Winifred, to the countless young students of the piano in Trinidad struggling with those eternal scales and sight reading?
Well, keep on struggling, that's all.
And that, I think, is the soundest and the brightest advice that we can get from any artist. And thank you for it, Winifred. Will you play one piece for us before you go?
Oh, yes. All right, then. Now, what would you like to hear?
Well, I know one of the most popular hits in Trinidad today is Hot Canary, and there I hope you know it.
The death of His Majesty King George VI brings sadness to the people. On August 31st of this year, Radio Trinidad reaches its first important milestone, 5 years of successful broadcasting. On August 31st of this year, Radio Trinidad reaches its first important milestone, 5 years of successful broadcasting. Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II broadcasts her first Christmas message.
Each Christmas at this time, my beloved Father, the Lord sends a message to His people in all parts of the world. Today, I am doing this to you, who are now my people. As He used to do, I am speaking to you from my own home, where I am spending Christmas with my family. And let me say at once, how I hope that your children are enjoying themselves as much as mine are, on a day which is especially the Children's Festival, kept in honor of a child born of Bethlehem nearly 2,000 years ago.
Listeners are thrilled with the first broadcast of the Tobago races. LegCo is open. A Royal Highness, the Princess Royal, arrives. Listeners are taken on a royal inspection tour of the St. John's Ambulance Brigade, the Girl Guides Association.
When, shortly before I left England, our Commissioner-in-Chief, Attorney General Sir Otto Lund, told me a little of the work of the St. John's Ambulance Brigade in this colony, I expressed to him my desire to meet you. That wish I am fulfilling this afternoon. And lastly, I would like to congratulate all the guiders, all those responsible for attending me this afternoon, and not least for the help part. She has worked very hard, and I hope we have given her satisfaction. I didn't know about that, but I hope we have very much. And I'd like to thank you very much.
Trinidad is moved by the tribute to the late Queen Mary by the Right Honourable Winston Churchill. The thrills of the coronation broadcast are brought into every home. Marian Anderson pays a visit to the island.
There is one welcome to Trinidad and Tobago on behalf of all our listeners. And I think that since this is your first working in tour, perhaps the first thing that we would like to hear from you is your impression of the West Indies. And this much I would like to say, I regret most sincerely that I have not known the West Indies much before now. Its people and the country, and the pleasure of knowing a little bit more of those, has been just a great, great, great pleasure to me.